Today, the road to the Final Four runs through Krzyzewskiville. Duke students dealing with frigid conditions here in North Carolina. Inside, the Cameron Crazies are poised for a Big East ACC showdown. Here on CBS, Georgetown on the road, the number 12 team of the country, taking on second-ranked Duke from Cameron Indoor Stadium. And welcome, everybody. Ian Eagle, along with Greg Anthony. We are expecting an incredible atmosphere, and this is a tremendous barometer game for both of these schools, two of the best in the nation right now, and two of the best young big men in all of college basketball going head-to-head.
Ian, you hit it right on the head. When you're talking about Kyle Singler and Greg Monroe, two young men who are matchup nightmares for opposing frontline players because of their versatility. Let's start with the heralded freshman, Greg Monroe. He can do so many things out on the basketball floor, one of which is to attack bigs off the dribble, get to the rim, and finish with contact. Also, he's defensively great presence out there, and his ability to find his vision, really one of the key attributes for Georgetown. Kyle Singler, he also can play out on the perimeter. He can stretch it to the three with the jump shot, but also the versatility to attack you off the dribble and get to the rim, and much improved defensively, getting out in passing lanes, creating easy opportunities in terms of scoring the basketball.
And right now, Greg, let's take a look at today's AT&T in-game analysis.
I am simply for Georgetown, handle the pressure, not just of Duke's perimeter defense, but of the Cameron Crazies. And if you're Duke, you're going to be smaller today without Zubek in the starting lineup. You have to limit the chip shots. Don't allow Georgetown to dominate the paint.
13th all-time meeting, Georgetown and Duke. CBS Sports coverage of NCAA men's basketball will continue after this message and a word from your local station. Georgetown and Duke today at Cameron. John Thompson III in his fifth season as the Georgetown head coach. And what a job he has done to bring this program back to prominence. Let's take a look at the starting lineups. Three guards set for the Hoyas. Wright, Freeman, and Sapp. Sapp is the only senior on this squad on scholarship. DaJuan Summers, one of the most improved players in the country, and one of the top freshmen, Greg Monroe, up front for Duke. Shire and Smith in the backcourt. Greg Paulus now comes off the bench. Kyle Singler, David McClure getting the start instead of Brian Zubek, and Gerald Henderson is the other player on the front court. Mike Krzyzewski, 29th year as the head coach at Duke. He said the crowd here has become more of an old-fashioned crowd. They've been very spirited. John Cal, Sean Hull, Jim Burr, the officiating crew. And today's game is being brought to you in HDTV by Harris Corporation, the world leader in broadcast systems for high-definition television and mobile media. Ian Eagle, Greg Anthony, the rest of our CBS crew ready for Georgetown-Duke. Greg, we know these are two teams that have two very distinct styles. Defensively, Duke will just get after you. That pressure defense in the half court, Georgetown, precision offense, everything is very much within the game plan offensively for G-Town.
It is, and the balance that they feature offensively, you have to guard all five at all times when you play against the Hoyas.
And we're underway here in Cameron. Chris Wright, the sophomore, the penetration, kick out, it's Freeman from the corner, it doesn't go, rebounded by Singler down low for Duke. Nolan Smith is running this Duke offense. Paulus now is a sixth man, or thought of as a sixth starter. Shire trying to make his move, gives up his dribble. Henderson. Now McClure getting a touch. 15 to shoot. First minute of play here in Durham. Shire. And a matchup with Freeman. 9 to shoot. Shire, the penetration. He got tripped up. McClure. Extra feed. Smith open look. Got it for three.
Excellent decision by McClure. He didn't force the shot underneath and was able to find Nolan Smith on the perimeter for the three.
Duke comes in averaging just under 81 points per game. They allow just 60. And a 70-56 win at Georgia Tech on Wednesday night. Georgetown, big win over Syracuse, 88-74 on Wednesday. An offensive explosion. Way outside, count it. The three ball goes down.
And that's the problem, Ian, right there that Monroe creates. His ability to take bigs off the dribble, forces help, and he finds on the perimeter.
Now Summers has that unlimited range for a big man, and a whistle on the other end. So Austin Freeman, big jump for him this year as well. Versatile, he can really shoot it, has the long-range capabilities. Now in his sophomore season out of DeMatha High School. Hard to believe, first player from DeMatha to go to Georgetown in 20 years.
When you think about the tradition DeMatha has and how many great players, and it's in your backyard if you're Georgetown, but John Thompson III has been able to bridge that gap and get them back on board with Georgetown's program.
So first team foul. New shot clock to work with. Henderson feeding down low. On a kick out for Smith. We've seen a lot of growth from him in his sophomore year. Out of Oak Hill Academy, Upper Marlboro, Maryland. He knows a lot of these Georgetown kids. And traveling the call against Singler. Well, winning here at home, at Cameron, out of conference. Duke does it as well as anybody. 67 straight home wins out of conference. Last loss came against a Big East team back in 2000, St. John's.
Yeah, and Georgetown early on, I think, looks very comfortable at dealing with Duke's pressure.
Right off the stop and go on a blocking foul call. Shire took the hit. So good penetration from Chris Wright. Natural point guard. He can create his own shot very quick. Out of Bowie, Maryland, McDonald's All-American. We got a bunch of McDonald's All-Americans littered throughout both of these
This
rosters.
Is like the McDonald's All-American game.
But not all McDonald's All-Americans translate into great college players.
That's a great point, Ian. And hard work oftentimes supersedes that.
Summers tried to dump it down low. Out of bounds, Greg Monroe.
And that last possession is a perfect example. Duke, one of the very best at having five sets of eyes on the basketball at all time. I love how they converge on the paint to force that turnover.
We are tied at three, just over 2 minutes gone by here in Durham. Shire puts it on the floor. Pull up, pop, short, air ball. Rebound from Chris Wright. Wright pushing tempo for Georgetown. Looking to go coast to coast. Lob and nobody's home. Henderson the other way for Duke. Numbers if they hurry. Singler breaking out for the slam.
And that's Duke right there. They want to turn you over and get out in transition. They have five guys also who can all find and finish.
Freeman handles the pressure off the looping feed. The floater goes down. Offensive foul. Count it. But that'll be number two on Austin Freeman.
And Duke in the open floor here. Gerald Henderson, perfect delivery to Kyle Singler, able to finish. But then Freeman comes right back. Nice little floater, but not able to withstand the pressure from Singler. He picks up the charge again. Remember, he's much improved defensively. Not just at guarding on the perimeter, but he's willing to stick his nose in. Coach Krzyzewski talked about it yesterday at practice. You can take charges against Georgetown.
The all-around skills of Kyle Singler, we're going to get into that four spot through the years for Duke. It's been such an integral part to their success, finding the right fit for that power forward position. Singler's probably more of a point forward, the way that he can handle the ball and spread it around.
Really much in the tradition of what they've had in the past. Yep. You think of Leitner and Ferry, guys who make good decisions with the basketball at all times and from all positions.
Singler. Jump shot doesn't go. Rebound controlled by Freeman. He's playing with two fouls. Freeman picked up by Shire. We are tied at five. Now Summers way out on the perimeter. McClure draws that assignment. Look at the defense from Duke. The drive. Summers breaks them down off the dribble. Tough move.
So fluid out on the floor and poised. Picks his spots very nicely when he wants to attack.
He has scored five of Georgetown's 7 points. Inside, Singler can't get it to drop. Wright pushing tempo. Great feed inside, and Monroe lays it in.
And the size of Georgetown is really creating problems for Duke in terms of their shot selection and the rhythm. They do not feel comfortable shooting the basketball against this length of Georgetown.
Remember, Greg Monroe considered going to Duke. It came right down to the wire. He chose Georgetown, and the fans here are well aware of that whole recruiting process. Henderson lets it fly. Book it. A three.
Duke has made a living throughout Coach Krzyzewski's tenure at really being good at knocking down three-pointers in timely possessions. And again, here, they're finding those opportunities.
Georgetown opens up 4 of 6 from the field. Duke is 3 of 5. Hoyas have a 1-point lead just about 5 minutes gone by in this first half. And it's going the other way, a moving screen, and Monroe can't believe it. A timeout, Georgetown 9, Duke 8. We're coming back to Cameron here on CBS. passion for basketball in this area unparalleled. Let's take a walk down Tobacco Road. Davidson Wild, led by Player of the Year candidate Stephen Curry, 13-3. North Carolina Tar Heels picked up their first ACC win at Virginia Thursday night. And Dino Gaudio's Demon Deacons remain unbeaten, 15-0. Huge game at undefeated Clemson coming up.
And there have been some magical wins. VMI knocking off Kentucky early on. Remember, they lead the nation in scoring, folks. UMass knocking off Kansas. And how about Harvard? Tommy Amaker, formerly a Duke player, and led them into Boston College after they had just knocked off North Carolina. And Todd Bozeman at Morgan State over Maryland. You know, and expect to see more of that, because that's what college basketball is all about right now. Parity. Everyone believes on any given night they can win.
Wholesale changes here for Krzyzewski. Paulus has checked into the game. Coach Seuss is in. Jumper doesn't go for Paulus. And rebound control. Single gets it in. Zubek, another change for Krzyzewski. Paulus, count it, a three.
And Zubek makes that play because of his size and presence. It forces the double team here. Great effort by Kyle Singler to save a layup.
Well, Singler didn't end up in the front row. He ended up in the third row.
That's what you call selling out right there. Leaving it on the floor. Take a look at Kyle Singler's legs. I noticed that practice. His legs, he's got more scars and scrapes, because that tells you the way he plays. He leaves it out there. He's not afraid to go on the floor to come up with loose balls or prevent layups, as he did against Greg Monroe.
ACC Rookie of the Year last season, inside, able to work it to Summers. And DaJuan Summers hurting this Duke defense, putting it on the floor and then posting up on the interior. 7 points for him. We are tied at 11. Martinez Pocsus, the junior from Lithuania. Paulus, he was a three-year starter at point guard. How is he handling coming off the bench? Huge adjustment for him, ego-wise.
It definitely is, but I tell you what, he started to get healthy, and that's one of the real issues here. Great effort by Zubac, but one of the...
And a tie-up on the inside. Duke will hold on to it. And near the end of today's game, we'll select a Chevrolet player of the game from each team in recognition of continued excellence on and off the court. Chevrolet will make a contribution to each university's general scholarship fund to support the development of new technologies and innovations. Jason Clark is in the game for Georgetown. Omar Watt also in. Shot clock winding down and a violation.
Mental breakdown there for Duke, not really recognizing what the shot clock was, and then unable to get off a shot in time.
So Clark is playing with Wright and with Watad for Georgetown, going with that three-guard set. Clark is more of a combo guard, and he can fill up a stat sheet. He's beginning to gain confidence in his freshman year from Arlington, Virginia. Clark on a pump inside. Summers wants it. Double team comes. Monroe. Pull-up pop. Count it for two.
And this is the concern for Coach Krzyzewski and having Zubek out there. It's a tough matchup defensively for him on Greg Monroe because of that versatility to step out on the perimeter.
Georgetown, 6 of 8 from the field. They've scored 8 in the paint, but able to bust his way inside. Elliott Williams. Quick jack doesn't go for Wright. Rebound tracked down by Singler. Williams is a freshman from Collierville, Tennessee. Lining it up, Singler can't get it to go for three. Monroe keeps it alive for Wright. And again, in transition, Wright draws defender. Summers is open. Cans it! A three from the corner to DaJuan Summers.
He knocks the three down, but Wright makes the play in transition. Has his head up, able to get into the teeth of the defense and find on the perimeter.
Boy, Summers is a rising star. He's got 10 points here. And a foul called as Paulus went down low. Watad got it.
Important. Get into the teeth. Look at that. Four defenders around him, and that gives him an ample opportunity to find on the perimeter. And Summers has been money early on in this game for Georgetown.
So Omar Watad picking up the personal. Four team fouls against Georgetown. Now, DaJuan Summers from Baltimore, Maryland, played a complimentary role behind the likes of Jeff Green and Roy Hibbert, waited his turn, experience has developed, and he is busting out in his junior season.
And that's one of the reasons why Georgetown is really, I think, exceeding a lot of people's expectations early on is because of his emergence as a player. Yes, Greg Monroe's been great. And, you know, Chris Wright, really like a freshman for him at the point guard. But I think the fact that you have a calming influence in your best player with Summers really provides that confidence for everybody else out on the floor.
Paula, 68% free throw shooter. Team player, a leader, a mentor, but I don't care who you are. If you start at a position for three straight years and you're told your senior season you're coming off the bench, that's a hit.
And not just any program. This at Duke.
Yep.
You know, a perennial power, and I think he's handled it about as well as you can. And let me tell you, in order for Duke to have a chance to achieve all their goals, he's still got to be good. He's a sixth starter even though he's coming off the bench.
And Georgetown will hold on to it, but Jason Clark having all kinds of trouble handling the basketball. 21 seconds remain on the shot clock.
Well, here Duke extending that pressure, and yeah, that's a good call. I thought Gerald Henderson might have got a hand on there to knock it out of bounds.
So Henderson back in for Duke. We see Lance Thomas for the first time, another one of those McDonald's All-Americans. He's the junior from Scotch Plains, New Jersey. Jesse Sapp handles it. Sapp has been having his problems. Just can't seem to find his stroke. Monroe bodied up by Zubek. And a foul call.
We talked earlier about DaJuan Summers. And when you're on the road in a hostile environment, you need your best player to be able to step up and take pressure off of everybody. And Summers has just been so good. And not just knocking down a perimeter shot, but also getting into the lane. And again, that calming presence is so important when you play on the road.
And knocked out of bounds. Georgetown will hold on to it. What did Coach Thompson tell us about Summers? His growth mentally and just reading situations. You can really see the experience out there on the court that's developed over his 3 years.
And that's a reflection of John Thompson III as well as a coach, because his players really have a great understanding. They don't just make the play. They see the play two and three steps ahead.
There's Monroe handling it like a guard out on the perimeter. Greg Monroe, the lefty, against Zubek. Zubek's not comfortable out there. Sapp pulls the trigger. No good. He continues to struggle. 37% from the field for the senior from Harlem, New York. Holds. He wants it. Short on a three. Loose ball. And Georgetown claims it. Clark will race it up the floor. Numbers if they hurry. A three-on-two developing. Sapp the penetration. Inside. Count it. Austin Freeman setting up underneath.
And Jesse Sapp, though he's struggling with the shot, he still makes a very good decision there in the open court to get the basketball to Summers for the layup.
Georgetown.
Freeman, I'm sorry.
Up by three. The number 12 team in the country. And we'll get a timeout. 11:37 to go in this first half. Right now, it's the Georgetown offense winning out over the Duke defense. Still early.
A lot of questions about with Coach Gillespie. This team's playing solid basketball. I think they're going to get rewarded with a top 25.
Oh! Wow! Gerald Henderson! He came soaring in for the slam. Wow! Off the timeout. What a play from the bench. Sapp the penetration and tipped home off the Monroe miss. It's points for Monroe. Henderson pull up. Wow, Gerald Henderson, a tremendous slasher, explosive leaper. And 7 points for Henderson. Freeman out on the perimeter, dealing with the student section just behind him. Latah. Now Clark trying to spread it, had his pocket picked by Shire. Shire will wait for his teammates to get down the floor. Georgetown leads by one. Shire, jump shot. Thomas, the board, stripped. As Sapp got a piece out of bounds.
Just a nice cross screen. They eat up bodies, and that leaves the lane wide open for Gerald Henderson. And then he comes back the next possession, knocks down a jump shot. And I really think Gerald Henderson, we talked a lot about Kyle Singler, but this guy's talent level and ability to score the basketball, I think, underrated. And I think he needs to just be more aggressive at times and try to take games over. He has the ability to play at that level.
Well, Gerald Henderson had that big jump between his freshman and sophomore year. Corner three, and that doesn't go for Singler. Singler having some problems with his perimeter game so far. Chris Wright. Ball got clogged by Nolan Smith. Just about at the halfway point of this first half. Clark able to beat Shire, but comes up short on the floater. Smith sets up in the half court. Singler is 1 of 5 from the field for Duke. Thomas asking for the ball on the inside, got knocked away. Now a run out. Right, extra feed. And inside, Greg Monroe will rock the rim.
And coming in, we thought it would be Duke in transition that would be more, have more of an impact. It's been Georgetown that's done the job getting out in transition, able to finish, giving Duke trouble.
We are in the fourth quarter. No time left, and the touchdown is under review.
Hey, guys.
Now let's take a look at our State Farm Coaches All-America basketball team candidate as selected by the National Association of Basketball Coaches. It is Gerald Henderson. Of course, his dad, Gerald Sr., played 13 years in the NBA, won 3 titles, 2 with the Celtics, 1 with the Pistons. Henderson, he's got just a world of talent.
He really does. And expect to see him play at the next level without a doubt. He can do it all. He can shoot it with range. He can put it on the floor. He also defends it well. And I think he's going to have to impose his will on this game if Duke wants to win.
22-19, Georgetown off the timeout. Krzyzewski didn't like what he saw from his team, really defensively, because Georgetown, Greg, as you touched on, able to get up and down the floor in transition. We didn't expect that.
I think Georgetown's probably 8 points better offensively than they were a year ago. And there's Gerald Henderson. That's what he's going to have to do. I really believe he's the one matchup offensively that can create a lot of problems for Georgetown.
Gerald Henderson averaging just under 13 and a half points per game. A long two-pointer off the deflection. Nearly a steal for Singler. Now a scrum for the loose ball. Sapp keeps it alive. Out of the corner. Freeman can't get it to drop. Rebound. Summers. Oh, he's a man in there.
Physical. He is physical. On both ends.
DaJuan Summers has 12 points. He and Monroe have combined 9 of 10 from the field.
And you know what the point of emphasis was for Duke defensively. Those two guys had to be contained.
Miles Plumlee, a freshman from Warsaw, Indiana, is into the game. Boy, Gerald Henderson, is he listening to the broadcast? He's taking over here in the first half for Duke.
He's doing a very good job. And I tell you what else has happened, Ian. The game is speeding up. And as the game speeds up, Coach Krzyzewski talked about this yesterday. We want to make Georgetown play fast. Even though they're an improved offensive team, that still, I think, works to the benefit of the Blue Devils.
Henderson with 11 points. He's 5 of 5 from the field. Sapp called for the offensive foul. Georgetown holding on to a 1-point lead. 16 fouls against the Hoyas. But Georgetown shooting it at 65% from the field. Singler makes his move, able to turn the corner and block Julian Vaughn, who just checked into the game for Georgetown. On a cross-court feed, Freeman open look, book it, a 3.
Chris Wright is doing such a good job in the open floor of finding. He gets into the lane and he finds. He's doing a great job at the point guard of making sure everyone stays involved offensively.
Austin Freeman is a silent assassin. You don't hear a lot about him, but he can make big shots. He's got 7 so far. Plumlee lines it up, and he's got it. Miles Plumlee averaging only 2 points per game. He's got his deuce right there.
But you can see defensively, Duke is starting to extend that pressure a little bit.
And Sapp tried to loop a pass inside for Freeman, out of bounds. 6th turnover for Georgetown. Little surfing for the Blue Devils. Right now they're down deuce. Right back here in Durham. Look at the game summary with Georgetown in front by 2. Shooting it well. 12 of 18 from the field. Duke is 10 out of 19, but 6 Hoya turnovers. They are controlling the paint so far, and Summers having a big day. 12 points. One of the unique things about calling a game here at Cameron, we're upstairs. As you can tell, this is not the norm in college basketball. Normally you're downstairs. It's like calling a football game for me. He's a big Steeler fan, so you've got other interests this week. Your impression so far from what you've seen out of Georgetown, first time you're seeing them in person.
Well, they played exceptionally well. I think what's interesting is how much bigger they are. Now, having said all of that, it's still a two-point game with them shooting over 60%, so if you're Duke, you still feel good about where you are when they're shooting it lights out.
Wright has five assists already, so Chris Wright is doing his job at the point guard position for Georgetown. They've outscored them 9-2 in transition, and another opportunity here. Wright, the acceleration, and blocked. He came up short as Duke was able to recover, and Henderson got back defensively.
Not giving up on the play. Gerald Henderson here, great body control, going away from the basket. Avoids the contact. And Nolan Smith makes a great play also, which allows Henderson to come up and finish off the block.
And Wright, the fend-off, blocking foul is called on Nolan Smith. Third team foul against Duke. Now visit CBSSports.com for a wrap-up of all the day's NCAA basketball action. Get the latest scores and stats, video highlights, in-depth analysis from our team of experts only at CBSSports.com. Georgetown gets it into Summers. He's been the go-to guy so far. Monroe has been solid, and Austin Freeman's made some plays out on the perimeter. Jesse Sapp, the senior, the circle to the rim, and he missed the layup with the offhand.
And offensively, Jesse Sapp really struggling, and somebody they're going to count on as the season progresses. He's got to find his rhythm offensively for Georgetown.
We are down to 6.5 to play in this first half. Georgetown 27, Duke 25. Plumlee seeing extended action. And a tie-up. Summers got to the freshman on the outside. And it's going the other way.
Just a savvy play by DaJuan Summers. Seeing the ball. Plumlee playing with it a little bit. He reaches right in to tie it up and turn that possession over to Georgetown.
Duke has now turned it over five times. Possession arrow in favor of the Hoyas. This is Monroe out front. Plumlee's got the defense. Latah tried the backdoor feed and a kick ball. Fortunate.
Oh. I don't know. It looked like Henderson got that with his forearm. Now, he did look to try and kick it, but I think the ball hit him off the forearm there. Tough break for Duke.
The Hoyas hold on to it. 24-second on the shot clock. Monroe on a kick out and a foul calls as he tried to take it inside. Plumlee was there defensively.
Yeah, and with the way that Duke likes to defend, they want to extend the pressure on the perimeter. They want to deny wings. Well, that middle of the floor opens up for a big if you have the ability to beat people off the dribble, which is what Greg Monroe possesses.
Yeah, one question coming in, could Duke rattle Georgetown here at Cameron? So far, the answer is no. Latah. Offensive foul. It's Monroe.
And Plumlee much better defensively. The reason Plumlee's out there, I think, of their bigs, he's probably got the most lateral quickness here. Great defense. Pressuring. Steps up. And again, he doesn't get blown by. He forces him into that charge. Great play by Plumlee.
And second personal foul on Monroe. Plumlee. His younger brother, Mason, is already committed to Duke. The family moved to Arden, North Carolina, mountain town, but originally from Indiana. Plumlee originally was going to go to Stanford until the coaching change took place. Ironically, Johnny Dawkins, former assistant at Duke, now the head coach at Stanford. Trent Johnson, former Stanford head coach, now at LSU. Monroe sits, Vaughn checks in, and a whistle inside as Duke was trying to work it out around the perimeter, then on a dump down. TV's number one drama has a new partner in crime. Lawrence Fishburne stars in a new episode of CSI Thursday on CBS, America's most watched network. He's a powerful actor. That's just my two cents.
I agree. I'm a big fan.
Free throw goes for Miles Plumlee, 43% on the season.
And Duke, again, even though it seems like and feels like Georgetown has been in control, this is a one-point game. And now 5:45 to go in this first half. You don't have Monroe out there to create that matchup problem for Duke. I'll be interested to see offensively how Georgetown executes now in the half court.
Henry Sims called on the foul. Another top 50 recruit for this Georgetown team. Talented big man who is beginning to show signs of fitting into this system. We are tied at 27. Plumlee gets a round of applause from this crowd.
Excellent effort. I think sometimes we forget just how young both these teams are.
Chris Wright running the offense here for Georgetown. He replaced Jonathan Wallace at that lead guard position, but he's more of a point guard. Summers. Oh. In and out.
It looks good even when it doesn't go down.
Sure does. And now Duke can grab the lead as we approach 5 minutes to play in this first half. Shire, give and go. Singler lays it in. Well executed.
And again, not having Monroe out there, you don't have the presence defensively. Duke now able to get into the lane and create havoc against Georgetown.
Julian Vaughn is now the big man here for Georgetown. And he's matched up with David McClure. Right. The five. Doesn't go for Summers. And foul called as Vaughn is able to draw it inside.
Shire, great penetration, forces help, and then Singler able to finish. And you see, he just reads the play. Anytime you drive baseline, you want that big from the top to dive to the rim. There's typically going to be an angle to deliver for a finish.
First free throw attempt of this first half for Georgetown, and it's Vaughn at the line, the transfer from Florida State, a banger, a big body. He was granted a waiver by the NCAA and did not have to sit out a season off of his transfer from FSU, originally from Reston, Virginia, and an Oak Hill Academy product. 53% shooter at the line. And he knocks down a pair. We are tied at 29-29, 4:35 to go, first half here in Durham.
And offensively, Kyle Singler's been pretty quiet. Monroe, I thought, did a very good job defensively.
Shire, count it, a three.
And Shire had been quiet as well, but he's starting to get a rhythm. I think they're starting now to get a little more comfortable of dealing with that length defensively of Georgetown.
And deflected inside is Wright. Tried the penetration. Out of bounds. Georgetown will retain it. And the Hoyas will use a timeout. 4:13 to play in the first half. Duke with a three-point lead over Georgetown. Jersey to practice yesterday, but that's you. That's okay.
I'm a diehard.
You really are.
Steeler fan. And there's a little bit of trepidation I got in my heart right now because I do have a lot of respect for that Ravens defense.
It's developed into a tremendous rivalry over the last 10 years. 9-2 run overall, 7-2 since Monroe sat for Georgetown. Jump shot doesn't go for Clark, and rebound controlled by Duke. 32-29, Blue Devils. They swing it. Henderson open look. Gerald Henderson drains the triple.
Great early execution in terms of that transition. Good ball movement from strong side to weak side to create that opportunity for Gerald Henderson.
Big first half for Henderson. 6 of 6 from the field, 14 points. Jump shot doesn't go for Wright. Sims was looking for position underneath. It's a 12-2 run for Duke. They lead by 6. Paulus using the screen. Now a switch. Small against big. Henderson can do no wrong in this first half as we approach 3 minutes to play. Anderson lines it up. He is smoking hot.
He is so good.
It is a 15-2 run. Within that run, 9-0 Duke. And McClure trying to step in using the body. Gerald Henderson. He's unconscious right now. Take a look at today's AT&T in-game analysis.
Well, Georgetown, they started to turn over 7. Duke's got 7 points off of that, but the chip shots have kept them in the game. 16-10 advantage for Georgetown.
And Greg coming up with Duke in front, 38-29. We've got AT&T at the half. Gus Johnson and Seth Davis will get you caught up on all the scores and highlights of a busy day in college basketball. Coming up, AT&T at the half. Oh, Seth Davis, 1992 Duke graduate. That's a man's man. I'm comfortable in saying that.
That's because you're in the hair.
Yeah,
you like the hair.
Look at that hair.
The brow and the smile. That's a very confident look by Seth Davis.
You know what? Can I use a word? Smoldering. Seth was one of those guys, by the way, back in his teeth. He wore the mask. Greg Monroe is back in, and they need him because since he left the game, it has taken a turn in favor of Duke.
His presence on the floor, because he can create offensively, takes pressure off of your guards when you're big, can do that. And without him on the floor, Georgetown has really struggled in the half court to score.
Georgetown led this one 27-23. Duke has outscored them 15-2 to take a 38-29 lead. Georgetown shooting 50% from the field. They've missed their last six. And a denial on the inside. Sims had it knocked down by Singler. Singler, pull up, hop. Short, struggling with his shot here today. Right up the floor in a hurry. Now they'll look for Monroe on the inside. Monroe is in a battle with Singler underneath. Duke's shooting percentage is up to 61% from the field. We come up on 2 minutes to play in this first half. Monroe on a dish. And a foul called. It's going the other way.
Gerald Henderson has really done it in a variety of ways. That mid-range jump shot, he's done it. The effort here defensively, and then the mismatch creates space and knocks down the three. He's feeling it perfect from the field.
Greg Monroe just got called on the personal. That is his third. Gerald Henderson, 17 points today. And Monroe couldn't believe it. He thought he got the call on the inside. Instead, the officials called it on the Georgetown big man.
I thought it was a good call because once he goes in and commits as a big, it's, even though he's versatile, it's tough for him to get control of his body and stop before he initiates the contact.
Paulus on a pump fake. Way outside. He's got 20 seconds to work with on the shot clock. Henderson directing traffic. He wants McClure out of there for an isolation. Now a switch. Henderson. He's human. Right, the rebound. Georgetown needs to get something going offensively. Clark lines it up. It rings out for three. And Krzyzewski tells Paulus, slow it down. Get into your half-court set. We got plenty of time to work with here as the Hoyas are 0 for their last 8 from the field.
And they've really been a different team without Monroe in the game. Even it's had an effect, I think, on Summers because he's not getting the same types of looks he did early in his game.
10 on the timer. 1 minute to go in the first half. Paulus using the Singler screen. Singler the cut. Look out. Singler lays it in.
How about Greg Paulus there with that play, though? Held on to the last possible moment and created that opportunity for Kyle Singler.
6 points for Kyle Singler. He averages just under 17 per game. Georgetown has gone ice cold. They trail by double figures. Right, the jumper. No. And McClure keeps it alive, controlled by Sapp. And Sapp got the bucket to drop, but a foul call. It'll be Paulus picking up his first. Well, impact players today. Monroe got off to the quick start, as did Summers. But so far, it's been the Gerald Henderson show in his first half.
It has. And Singler's starting to, I think, emerge now offensively down the stretch. Again, not having Monroe out there, but Gerald Henderson, you hit it right on the head. He's really answered the call early on. And I think he gave his team a real shot of confidence when he started to take the game over. And he has that ability. And I think as he goes, this Duke basketball team will go.
Now 1-1 for Sapp, unable to hit. Georgetown has missed its last 9 shots from the field. It's an 11-0 run for Duke. And that's the difference here. 11-point lead, 40-29. Duke can hold for 10 seconds left. The offense will run through Singler. 5 seconds left. Singler makes his move. The curl to the rim. And a block. Clean block as time expires in this first half. But Duke really put it together in the late stages of the first half. A 17-2 run to end it. 40-29, the number two team in the country, leading Georgetown at the end of the first half. Right now, let's go to Gus Johnson in New York. CBS Sports College Basketball coverage is sponsored by the new AT&T, your world delivered. Buffalo Wild Wings, you have to be here. And by your local authorized Mercedes-Benz dealer. Time here at Duke, 40-29. Blue Devils in front of the Hoyas. Welcome back, everybody. Not courtside, upstairs. Ian Eagle along with Greg Anthony. What a tremendous atmosphere it is here at Cameron. But you could feel the game change. There were two very distinct moments. One of them involved Gerald Henderson in that first half.
And give credit to Coach Krzyzewski, because his design of the inbounds play really started him on his run. And he did a great job here of executing, getting out in transition, and knocking down the jump shot. And again, he's got a great rhythm offensively, and here's just an amazing defensive play. And then there he was in his own mismatch with the big. He did such a good job of setting the tone offensively during that run.
Right now, let's take a look at the DirecTV first half stats. Georgetown controlling the stats early in this game, but Duke really took over on the offensive end. The other point where you could feel the game change when Greg Monroe left the game in foul trouble. Georgetown has had a tough time bouncing back from that. We were tied at 29. Duke ended the half on an 11-0 run. McClure, the drive. The floater for David McClure, and he gets Duke on the board first in this second half.
And I was interested to see how Monroe would play with three fouls. Remember, he's a freshman with three fouls, and McClure attacks him right off the bat. And you see he was reluctant to put forth the effort defensively.
Here's Austin Freeman. He got into early foul trouble with a couple of personals. And Monroe on the outside. How many Georgetown players scored in the first half? Latad, little flip doesn't go.
Well, that's a great one. Only three guys had the opportunity to see the basketball go through the hoop. Conversely, Duke had seven guys score a field goal, and you're a better player when you score the basketball.
Well, in that first half, Singler held to 6 points and five rebounds. Henderson with a 17-point first half effort. And you felt Paulus came in and really helped.
I thought he set the tone. He really initiated well offensively, didn't turn the basketball over, and was able to score as well. Again, if he plays well, I think that's when Duke as a basketball team goes to another level.
Georgetown has missed on its last 11 shots from the field. So Jason Clark getting the nod in this second half as it's stolen away by Smith and lays it in. The steal in the bucket for the sophomore, Nolan Smith.
Relentless defensively, Duke. They're picking up right where they left off that last 5.5 minutes of the first half. And Georgetown unable really to get into a rhythm offensively and finally able to break the drought there, Ian.
Well, Greg Monroe could be the best passer on this team. And he finds Jason Clark, the combination guard, underneath. But obviously John Thompson III was not happy with his starting five. He made changes to open up this second half. Shire, short, rebound. Watad's got it for the Hoyas.
And on the road, I don't care how good you are, if you miss 10 consecutive shots against a good basketball team, you're going to find yourself in trouble.
Well, Clark and Watad played a big role in that win over Syracuse. Monroe losing the ball, fight for it underneath. And we've got a tie-up. And possession arrow right now favors Georgetown. The big three for the Hoyas. Summers got off to the quick start, finished with 12 points. Monroe, the freshman, with eight. Freeman knocking down some shots from the perimeter.
And they've been fine. The problem is no one else offensively really has stepped up.
Shouldn't be the big three. It's the only three. Yeah. Now here's a fourth. Jason Clark has decided to join the party as he buries the three.
And offensively, Jason Clark, this young man can get it going on the perimeter.
Henderson had the big first half in a matchup with Watah. Henderson, the curl, open look. Singler, no, off the rim. Rebounded by Summers. Summers now 17 straight double-digit scoring games for him, the junior. And Singler is 3 of 11 from the field. Goes down for Monroe. The versatility and the agility of the big man.
Yeah, and avoiding the contact, not really picking up the charge here. Very smart play by Greg Monroe.
Well, the scouting report is he can dominate a game without scoring. dishing the ball, setting screens defensively. Henderson off the mark. That rebound controlled by Summers for the Hoyas. Summers, the drive, the body from McClure, and a foul called. Summers will shoot a pair. Well, this week, Dave's got Will Smith, Tom Cruise, Jerry Seinfeld, and Dustin Hoffman. Impressive guest list. Monday, catch Jennifer Aniston and a top 10 with Jim Carrey, only on CBS. Now, DaJuan Summers playing that power forward role. Could be a small forward down the road, depending upon where his basketball life takes him. Why don't we check out the blog on DaJuan Summers?
He's the package offensively. By that, I mean he does everything. He finishes, he fills, and he finds out on the basketball floor. And again, that last possession is perfect because I'm always under control. That really sets the tone for this basketball team. Just a pleasant disposition out on the floor. Yep. In terms of how he attacks the game of basketball.
Good size, good strength, athletic. He's got 14 points to lead Georgetown. And the Hoyas creeping back into it. Shire, that's a three. Rebounded by Singler. Got some contact and sticks with the play.
Great effort. Stays with it. Doesn't get it on the first try, but able to get that offensive rebound and finish.
And that ends a 9-0 Hoya run. It's 46-38 Duke. Freeman had it intercepted by Henderson. Nearly gave it back, and now he does. Up the floor, 3-on-2 developing. Summers. And the foul.
Young fella.
DaJuan Summers.
How about the body control? Again, we talk about under control. This is under control here. He goes, he shows it, brings it back, creates the contact, and still finishes. Ill-advised pass there by Gerald Henderson. Again, the look ahead, allowing Summers to make that play. That pass ahead really makes that play because you put now your offensive players into attack mode when you push the ball and kick it ahead with the pass.
And Summers knocks down the free throw. Now, think about it this way. Monroe, the presence that he brings, second half with him in the game, 12-6 in favor of the Hoyas.
And you made the point earlier, Ian, he can dominate a game without scoring it because of the overall skill set and the understanding as a freshman of how to play the game of basketball.
And they tried a backdoor feed. Shire had it knocked away. And a timeout with 15:52 to go. Duke up by 5 of the Hoyas. Right now, only 3 unbeaten teams remain in Division I play. Pittsburgh, 16-0. They're ranked number 1 in the country. Wake Forest, Demon Deacons, 15-0. They're ranked number 3. And the Clemson Tigers, 16-0, ranked number 9. Wake and Clemson will meet later today. This is a big non-conference battle between these two schools. And the obvious question, who's better, Big East or ACC?
Well, Coach Krzyzewski, I think, really takes homage with the fact that the ACC is not getting the kind of press that they have in years past. But the last few years, let's face it, the Big East has been better, I believe. Yes, the bottom maybe not as good, but that's 16 teams, folks. They're going to probably put 9 in. And I think the ACC has every opportunity to put 6, maybe 7 into the tournament this year.
Now, Georgetown on a 12-2 run. The jump shot does not go for Paulus. And the tide has turned here in the early stages of the second half in favor of Georgetown. They trail Duke by 5. Monroe. And a handoff. Summers. Crossover. Left hand. And he draws the foul.
And beautiful drive and crossover change of direction there by Summers. You know, there's a simple stat. It's called a plus-minus. It's done a lot in the NBA, but in college it speaks volumes. And it talks to the presence. You know, a lot of stats sometimes can be overrated, but this one's not. Georgetown's plus 10 in this game when Greg Monroe is on the floor, which means when he's not there, minus 15. So that tells you how important he is to everything they do, both offensively and defensively.
Summers, a 75% free throw shooter. And nails the first. If you haven't discovered TV's number one new show, tomorrow is your chance. Simon Baker stars in a new episode of The Mentalist tomorrow after NFL coverage right here on CBS. Summers 4-4 at the free throw line and 4-5. 18 points, 5 rebounds, 6 of 9 from the field. Duke has a 46-42 lead over Georgetown. We saw Miles Plumlee get some opportunities in the first half. He's in there now. Duke turns the ball over, though. Freeman up the floor, met by Plumlee. Freeman shakes him on the baseline. Floater, no. Rebound, Singler had it, and a push.
And I tell you, Singler's not shooting it well, but he's doing a great job in the effort area in terms of rebounding and defense. Here he comes in and comes up with that loose ball. Good call by the official there.
It's going to be Henry Sims picking up the personal first team foul against Georgetown. Singler is 4 of 13 from the field. Does have 9 rebounds.
And that's the sign of a very good basketball player is he doesn't allow his jump shot to determine his impact on the game. And that's what Kyle Singler's doing tonight. No, he's not shooting with the consistency he's done in the past. And there it is.
Technical. John Thompson III just got teed up. And they're pointing behind the bench to one of the fans. John Cal had been having deeper discussions with Thompson along the sideline. Thompson said something there, but that's not where the technical came. It's when Cal turned around. And the Georgetown bench is, again, indicating that it came from behind the bench area.
And it looked like one of the assistants even was trying to take credit for the technical foul, for at least what was said.
John Shire at the free throw line. That was all a byproduct of the foul that was called on Sims.
And we're getting word that the technical was actually on Monroe.
Oof.
Which would be huge because he already has 3 fouls. Oh, that's his 4th. That is a huge play in this basketball game.
Wow.
We talked about that plus minus. Now, remember, 6-point lead for Duke. Monroe not in the game. This next 3-4 minute stretch could be the basketball game.
48-42. And contact there between Watad and Singler going body against body. So Jim Burr makes that call down on the floor.
Double foul, I think, is the call.
Yep. So the double foul against Watad and Singler. And the officials might be trying to calm things down right now as well and set the tone with 14:55 to go in this second half. Duke triggers in. Paulus and Smith now playing in the backcourt together.
And Shire, they've gone small.
Paulus, ball fake, little stutter step, pull up, rims out, rebounded, Singler, and he cleans it up on the interior.
Now, that first half, Georgetown did a good job of controlling their defensive backcourt. Here in the second half, though, offensive rebounds, that's 2 possessions where Singler's been able to convert on an offensive glass.
Double-double, Shire the steal. Shire's got the angle and leans in for 2.
And this is going to be a critical stretch for Georgetown. Again, we talked about it earlier. You cannot emphasize enough the importance of having Greg Monroe on the floor.
Timeout, Hoyas. 6:01 quickly without Monroe out there. Duke has regained control. They've got a 10-point lead here in the second half. Leads by 10. This past summer, coach Mike Krzyzewski led Team USA to a gold medal at the Beijing Olympics. USA with a 118-107 win over Spain to capture the gold. Now, keep in mind, coaches do not receive medals, so this was a gesture from the entire team to place their individual medals around the neck of Mike Krzyzewski at the ceremony. And you can just imagine the bond that developed between those players and their coach. He told us it was a once-in-a-lifetime experience.
It was 3 years in the making, 3 years of a commitment from him for that gold medal.
Talked about how special those players are to him and to his family. He also knew that they had to win. He felt some pressure, a lot of pressure, to get it done. Off the timeout, Freeman, the runner, follows his own miss and puts it in. Austin Freeman, he's got some toughness to him. The sophomore from Mitchellville, Maryland, he's got 9 points.
If you're Georgetown, this is a great opportunity for some of your younger players to grow because they're going to be counted on to make contributions now with Monroe out of the game.
Singler had the right idea, but he could not get it to Plumlee. Turnover. Freeman whips it ahead. Jason Clark, the freshman. And Georgetown will hold on to it. So the talented big man, Greg Monroe, major recruit, McDonald's All-American, two-time Mr. Basketball in the state of Louisiana, but he's in the role of spectator right now with four fouls, three personals, and a technically received for jawing on the bench.
And I'm a big fan of that rule because a part of playing the game is dealing with adversity. Going on the road, maybe calls not going against you. You have to maintain your composure. And this will be a learning curve for him.
Well, they're asking a lot of Henry Sims to now step in. He just gave the ball away, trying to get it to Jesse Sapp. And a foul call. 12th turnover for Georgetown, fourth in the second half.
And credit Duke for understanding. Without Monroe, Georgetown's a different basketball team. You can see the pressure. The ante being lifted up by them in terms of initiating intensity, getting after it on the perimeter, denying wings.
8-point lead for Duke. Smith makes his move. Hole clogged up by Sims. Stutter step. And a floater. Greg Paulus. 9 points off the bench for the Syracuse native. Now Summers trying to take over on a spin. And he draws the foul. DaJuan Summers going to the free throw line. What makes the hit comedy The Big Bang Theory such a blast? See for yourself Monday on CBS, America's most watched network. Well, Greg Monroe, 5 of 5 from the field, 10 points. He hasn't been the big scorer for Georgetown. It's been Summers who's done most of the offensive work putting points on the board. But as you and I have discussed, Monroe occupies the Duke defenders. You have to worry about him. He's a threat even when he doesn't have the ball.
And that's a great word, Ryan, that you use, because people often talk about making people better. They don't mean just with your ability to either score or get someone an open shot. It's with your ability to occupy, to have three sets of eyes on you, to have the focus be on you. And when you have the ability to allow that to get others involved, which he does, it has a tremendous impact on the game.
And Summers knocks down the free throw. It's 54 to 45. 19 for DaJuan Summers, their top returning scorer from last season's team, when he averaged 11 points per game. Smith handles it. Shire on a curl to the rim. Left hand. No. And rebounded by Summers. Poked away. And he's out of bounds.
And how about Greg Paulus? Again, we talked about his impact. He's kind of the emotional leader for the Blue Devils right now. He's getting the crowd into the game. Just a heady play to come from the weak side. Summers was not aware, and he creates that turnover.
So Duke holds onto it. Cut to the rim. Smith. He was met there by Julian Vaughn. And now Duke will reset it. Plenty of time on the shot clock. Paulus calls out a play. Ball movement. Paulus, long three.
He's feeling it. He's feeling it.
Well, Mike Krzyzewski told us in the victory over Georgia Tech, it was the first time all season where Paulus began to look like himself. That was Wednesday night. We have seen a carryover here today at Cameron. Crossover by Sapp. They've extended to a 12-point lead, 57 to 45. Vaughn inside. He got tied up. And a foul call. But Paulus and Sapp exchanging words. A timeout. Game summary in this second half. Georgetown got off to a very good start, but Duke has been able to withstand that, and now Duke has regained control. As we welcome you back, Ian Eagle along with Greg Anthony, and let me just end the speculation. We did plan the whole outfit match. I know I'm admitting it, but it happens. All right, let's talk about what Duke has done here in the second half. And Greg Paulus, who has been a forgotten man for this Duke team this year.
And he's really the sixth starter on this basketball team. And here he's stretching that defense, knocking down the three, getting into the lane here. A little floater, I like that. But this was the big play. He knocks this shot down here. You can see he's one of the real emotional leaders of this basketball team. I don't think anybody else has the impact on the fans that Greg Paulus does.
Well, one of the captains of this team. Excellent shooter his first 3 years with Duke, but not this season. He's been struggling with that shot, 35% from the field. And yeah, Coach Krzyzewski talked about the issues, had knee issues over the summer, couldn't play. Finger injury as well, and that's affected his shooting. Singler was called for that foul, his third, and Omar Watad at the line. 75% shooter coming up Monday on CBS. The laughs are 2.5 times bigger on TV's number one comedy. Charlie Sheen, John Cryer star in the new 2.5 Men. Monday on CBS, America's most watched network. And Watad misses on a pair. Well, Kyle Singler leads Duke this season in points, rebounds, assists, and steals. Back in 1991, Christian Laettner led the Blue Devils in four categories. Henderson on the breakdown. 19 points for Gerald Henderson. He has stepped forward here today.
Duke's gone small. You're going to look for them to spread the floor as they did there and create driving opportunities on the perimeter.
Here's Sapp giving it up. It has been very quiet here today for Wright. Still looking for his first field goal. Sapp couldn't grab it. And out of bounds. Opposing point guards coming into Cameron. A lot of the pressure will fall on them as Monroe returns for Georgetown. They've been a different team without him on the floor.
The ball doesn't move. The bodies don't move. Really what Georgetown is known for in terms of that motion offense with ball movement, body movement, has not existed when Monroe has been on the bench.
Anderson had the hole clogged up by Summers. Shire on the outside. We approach the midway point of this second half. Shire off the drive. Henderson to Smith. Shot clock is down to six. Smith knifing down the lane.
By going small, Duke has created matchup problems. Now you got Greg Monroe with four fouls, not wanting to really challenge defensively. Take a look here. Monroe is reluctant to even make a play on that shot, and Nolan Smith giving credit for recognizing that, using that quickness to get to the rim. And we talked about this earlier, how do young players deal with foul trouble?
Yep.
They don't necessarily always know how to be aggressive and when to use their body and things of that nature. That's been the case early on here with him coming back at the fourth foul.
Georgetown turns it over on the other end. And Monroe in there with four fouls. Duke is shooting it at 55% today. Krzyzewski told us about the chemistry. Good kid, still developing. Even the kids that were on the team last year are kind of playing in different roles. They're being asked to do a bit more. Shire, little fend off and a foul called as Clark was there defensively. Well, the Duke Blue Devils, big three today. Singler, Henderson, and Paulus all in double figures. Singler's got a double-double.
They've been effective in all areas. They've defended well. You know, you think about it, since Georgetown started 12 of 18 from the field.
Paulus. And rebound to Georgetown as Jason Clark is able to handle it. Clark will bring it across. Tough defense on Wright. Spin move. And Wright's got it to go. And the foul. First field goal of the day for the sophomore, Chris Wright.
We see it. He gets into the lane and he initiates contact there, but you can do that if you have the defensive player leaning. Greg Paul is unable to really establish position defensively, and Chris Wright takes advantage.
Well, Chris Wright was actually thinking about becoming an ACC player. He had committed to North Carolina State in high school, backed out when Herb Sendek left the program and then made his way over to Georgetown. Last year, tough season for him because of the left foot injury. Did come back for the NCAA tournament, but was limited to 16 games. So this is almost like an extended freshman season for Chris Wright. Oh, the cut and the block for Wright on Smith. Inside, Singler. He can't put it in. And the rebound controlled by Monroe. And a foul called on Singler in the backcourt. Fourth personal on Cahill Singler.
Good play here. Great effort by Singler. He stays with the play there. A little bit of frustration swinging the arm there.
Yep. Omar Watad went down to the floor. And we've seen that pick up here in the second half. A little more body bumping. Words being exchanged.
All right, it's not just hot up here.
Yeah.
It's hot down on the floor, too. The intensity level, it's rising out there. There's a sense of urgency by both teams, and you like that. You just want to make sure, as a player, you can control your emotions.
So it's not just me. The heat has gone up a notch up here.
I got a little respiration under the arm myself there.
That might have been a little too much information, but I'm with it. 61-48 Duke. As Krzyzewski huddles up with his team.
Good stoppage of play here because, again, these are young teams. I think sometimes we forget, you know, because the skill level is so high on both sides, and that's an intentional foul.
So Singler picks up the intentional foul against Watan. 10 points, 13 rebounds, 4 fouls. Singler is 5 of 16 from the field. And Watan to the free throw line. We already missed on a pair. This time he knocks it down. Two out of two for Watad. Get away from the cold with an all-new CSI Miami. Monday on CBS, America's most watched network. So Singler will take a seat. Two shots and the ball after the intentional foul. And Georgetown with a chance to cut this back to single digits. 9:23 to play in the second half. Jason Clark will handle it, defended by Smith for Duke. Watad out front. He got the second half start for Georgetown. Freeman looking down low. Monroe getting the ball. Rejected by Henderson. And laid home by Austin Freeman. That was a big time block by Gerald Henderson, who went up high to get it.
Monroe was a little tentative with how he attacked, but Gerald Henderson was not. Aggressive block shot.
Second block for Henderson, but 2 points on that possession for Georgetown on the Freeman layup. Henderson, the curl to the hoop, and he finishes.
We talked about earlier, they got 5 guards on the floor right now. They're going to space the floor and look to attack Georgetown off the dribble, and that's where Henderson's gotten his last 2 baskets.
21 points, 9 of 11 from the field. McClure is the biggest man on the court right now for Duke at 6'6", 215, senior from Ridgefield, Connecticut. Summers will try it, a three, and rims out. Foul call on Freeman.
And you can go small when you got a Gerald Henderson because he's listed at 6'4", 6'5", but he plays 6'7", or 6'8". And when you play big, it allows you, it gives you a lot of versatility if you're Mike Krzyzewski. And it creates matchup problems for Georgetown when you have the basketball.
63-52. Duke. Freeman called on his third personal foul. 16 fouls against Georgetown. We hit the 8-minute mark here at Cameron. Shire defended by Watah. Now a switch. Monroe draws the assignment. 7 to shoot. Smith, penetration, the runner. Soft touch, doesn't go. Rebound is cleared by Monroe.
That's still a quality possession, though, if you're Duke, because you utilize the entire shot clock and you get a look at the rim.
Freeman turns the corner, but he missed it. Down to 7:24 and counting left in this second half. 63-52. Duke, the number 2 team in the country in the coaches' poll. Only lost. loss this season came at Michigan. John Thompson, the third set. Yeah, their offense, it's like a cousin to our offense. Similarities, but a little different. No longer really thought of as the Princeton offense. It's the Georgetown offense. You feel that's the right way to do it.
That is the way to describe it.
Off the miss, it's rebounded by Clark. Still has the Princeton principles. Clark, pull up, pop, book it. And timeout taken. Georgetown calls a timeout. And it's single digits, 6:50 to play. Duke 63, Georgetown 54, a 9-2 Hoyas run. Coming up next, our road to the Final Four continues. James Harden and the Sun Devils tangle with Darren Collison and the Bruins of UCLA. Right here on the home of the NCAA Men's Basketball Championship, CBS Sports. Have some big-time talent in attendance there.
Oh, that's going to be amazing. And, you know, keep an eye on UCLA. They're quietly putting themselves in a position for a number one seed. Pac-10's a little down. They're playing well. Arizona State, really the team, I think, there to challenge in the Pac-10, so that should be a very good matchup.
Well, in this ACC Big East battle, ACC has won 8 of the 14 head-to-head matchups so far this season. It's rare. Second half of January, you would see a non-conference game like this. The intensity has been there from the start. And a break in the action with 6:40 to go, and Duke in front. CBS Sports College Basketball coverage is sponsored by EAS. Don't waste your workout. Finish it with EAS Myoplex. DirecTV. If you call yourself a sports fan, you gotta get DirecTV. And by Budweiser Select. Full flavor, 99 calories. The exception to the rule. Cameron Indoor Stadium, better than 9,000 on hand with Duke in front, 63-54. What has been the formula for success for the Blue Devils here today, Greg?
It's been about everything. When you look at Duke, it's been the athleticism of Gerald Henderson and his ability. It's been the effort of Singler. And it's also the energy of Greg Paulus and really being that senior leader out on the floor, rallying the crowd and giving his team, I think, energy. And that's important, and we've seen that from them.
Now look at the game reset. Georgetown with a couple of timeouts to work with. Duke still has 20 team fouls, 8 of them for Duke, 6 for Georgetown, and possession arrow favors Duke right now. We touched on it before we went to break about playing a big non-conference game in January. One of the benefits for these two teams just participating in a game like this, normally when you're playing your conference schedule?
Well, because the conference, every conference has a style that they play. But in order to win a national championship, you're going to have to beat a team with which your style you may not be familiar. So both these teams have an opportunity to see what else is going on in the country and where they have to improve and adapt if they ultimately want to have a chance to win that title.
Zubek sets the screen. Shire, shot clock winding down. McClure, offensive foul. The fendoff against Watan. And Watan has brought some energy to this Georgetown team out of Joseph City, Tennessee, the sophomore.
Slides his feet. See, he gets the chest in front. And then McClure then extends with that elbow just enough to draw the charge. Big possession out of a timeout for Georgetown.
Third personal against David McClure. Started his 20th game in a Duke uniform here today. 63-54. Monroe way outside against Zubek. Tried the backdoor bounce. And it does draw a foul as Summers was trying to angle his way towards the rim. It was Paulus who got in the way.
Yeah, the crowd's a little upset, but you can have fouls even though someone doesn't have possession of the basketball there. And the feet aren't there. So you can still have a charge or a block called even though possession of the basketball had been lost.
And double bonus now for Georgetown. Zubek will sit, replaced by Singler, playing with 4 personal fouls. And DaJuan Summers at the free throw line.
And free throw shooting, you know, 9-point game, 6 minutes to go, could be critical. And Georgetown, one of the better, 73% as a team, although only 10 of 15 so far here tonight.
And Duke is 6 of 6 from the line. Summers, no good on the first. Wasted opportunity here for DaJuan Summers. He's got 19 points. And Summers and Nolan Smith, they know one another. Summers from Baltimore, Maryland. Nolan Smith from Upper Marlboro, Maryland. Smith has played with all these guys. Wright, Summers, Freeman, Clark, AAU ball. going back to their high school days.
A lot of talent on this field. Just a tremendous amount of ability.
A lot of talent in the state of Maryland, yeah. Apparently, too. As Summers misses on a pair. Singler's got the board. A new career high for him. Rebounding. 14 for Kyle Singler, the sophomore from Medford, Oregon. And Duke content in spreading the floor, using some clock here with 16 to shoot. Blue Devils taking their time. 10 on the timer. Singler lets it fly.
Go! Great recognition by Gerald Henderson. Breakdown defensively by Monroe, and he doesn't get out.
Oh, the toughness of DaJuan Summers wheeling to the rim on a stutter step move.
They run a little pick and roll, and Monroe was just late to recover to his man, and Summers right back at them. And you see there, just beautiful shot. That could really get him going offensively. I love the fact that he's continued to compete, even though the shot hasn't fallen consistently. You mentioned a career high in rebounds. The effort, the energy, the intensity, it never wavers. That's why Duke wins. That's why Georgetown wins. These teams both have learned that even though shots may not fall, you can still impact the game in a positive way.
And now Summers having major problems at the free throw line. Now 5 of 10 from the stripe. I've heard Coach Krzyzewski make comparisons for Kyle Singler. It's almost like a combination of Shane Battier and Mike Dunleavy Jr. And you can see elements of both of those guys in his game.
The way he described it, he said, Singler's getting to a point where when he touches the basketball, the next thing that happens for us is good.
Yeah. And on cue.
On cue, right there. And that's, again, recognition. Understanding where he is, where the defense is on the floor, allows that play to materialize.
And there's something to be said for making the right basketball play when you touch the ball, especially at that spot for Duke, that four spot, that power forward position. Inside, Austin Freeman. He's burly. 6'4", 239 pounds, and a load to deal with. Singler, though, the all-around effort. 15 points, 15 boards, 10-point game. Well, for Duke, the first half belongs to Gerald Henderson. It's Kyle Singler who's taken over here in the second half. Game reset. Georgetown does have one timeout remaining. Hoyas are in the double bonus. Possession arrow right now favors Duke. Foul trouble for Duke. Four apiece on Singler and McClure. And we know about the foul trouble for Georgetown. It's Greg Monroe with four.
And the difference a year makes. A sophomore Singler with four, yet his impact on the game has not wavered. Whereas with Monroe, a little unsure of himself. He's had a few mental letdowns, which is expected from a freshman.
There's Shire on the perimeter. 9 to shoot. Under 4 minutes to play now. We're in the second half. Paulus roaming baseline. Outside. Henderson. No. Singler battling underneath. And jarred loose out of bounds. Last touch by Duke. Georgetown will have the ball. Trailing by 10 here in Durham when we come back. With a 68-58 lead over Georgetown. We've got 3:51 to go here in the second half. The game reset. 16 fouls for Georgetown. Kyle Singler, he's been the go-to guy in this second half for Duke, and the impact of underclassmen around the country, including here.
Yeah, and he does everything well. He leads them in scoring. He leads them in rebounding. He leads them in steals, and he also leads them in assists. Just a talented, talented basketball player. And again, I love the fact that no matter whether the shot falls, the effort remains consistent.
3:51 to play, though. Big possession here for Georgetown. They trail by 10. In that victory over Syracuse, they got 29 points from their bench. They have 11 points off the bench here today. John Thompson, the third's team, is 12-3, ranked number 12 in the nation in the latest coaches poll.
And I don't think, even if they lose, that they drop from that position, because they beat a very good Syracuse team. And look, anybody would struggle with Duke on the road here. Beautiful recovery there by Freeman, and the find to Clark for the finish.
even with a loss here, it doesn't change the way you view this team.
A competitive game at Duke against a team that is, you know, number two or three, depending on the poll in the country, does not hurt you. All it does is give you experience. Remember, this is a very young team. They're basically a freshman at the point and the center position, the two most important ones on the floor.
Henderson, the attack. Oh, hanging and lays it in. Timeout. Gerald Henderson is a high flyer. 23 points. 10-point lead for Duke. AFC Championship tomorrow here on CBS. The Baltimore Ravens, the Pittsburgh Steelers. A battle out of the AFC North. Number one defense, Pittsburgh. Number two defense in the NFL, Baltimore. You could be staring at 13-7, 10-6, one of those old-fashioned
games. Can you hand me my terrible towel? Right there,
yeah,
right?
You did bring it with you. You packed it in your luggage. You are committed. That's going to be a good one here on CBS.
It really is.
I know who you got. Outside for Jason Clark. And intercepted. That's a bad pass by the freshman. And Duke is in control. They are up 10 with 2:42 left. 14th Georgetown turnover. Hoyas will have 13 straight games within the Big East after this one. So they'll get back to conference play. This is a team that was picked 7th in the preseason poll by the Big East coaches. Henderson driving to the hoop in traffic and slapped out of there, out of bounds. 7 to shoot for Duke. Well, second half of our doubleheader coming up out of the Pac-10. Number 15, Arizona State taking on number 7, UCLA. Stay tuned for that one. We'll have the final 2:23 when we come back. Now, Duke is running a 7-game winning streak, and they're trying to close this one out with 2:23 left. Look at the game reset. This all-time matchup is tied at 6-6, 13th meeting between these two schools. And coming up for Duke in the conference with NC State and Maryland and Wake Forest. I know you're very high on the Demon Deacons from what you've seen.
Look, with all due respect, I think Duke's a fabulous team. We obviously know how good North Carolina is. Wake may be the most talented of the three.
Smith, the drive. It was poked out of there. Shot clock winding down and a turnover. This could be one last gasp from Georgetown if they can go on a run here. Monroe turning, and he made it look very easy on the interior.
That's a lefty going to the right shoulder baseline. And remember, Singler with the four fouls, not going to be too aggressive at this stage to give the possibility of a three-point play.
12 points for Greg Monroe. 6 of 7 from the field. We're under 2 minutes to play now here at Cameron. 70-62 Duke. 15 to shoot. Shire, high screen from Singler. Needs some help now. Shot clock is down to 7. Singler lets it fly. Side rim and rebounded by Shire. And they can use more clock. And a foul call. DaJuan Summers along the sideline. And Shire is an excellent free throw shooter at 83%.
Yeah, what a luxury if you're Duke to have your backcourt. Shire, 83. Nolan Smith shoots 93. You know, Gerald Henderson shoots 80. So that's a big luxury if you're Duke down the stretch of games to have that kind of confidence and knowing you can go to the line and finish.
John Shire out of Glenbrook North High School, same high school that produced Duke assistant coach Chris Collins. Shire was Mr. Basketball in the state of Illinois as a senior. Duke as a team now 7 of 7 from the free throw line. And tack on another. 10-point lead for Duke. 1:25 to go. Freeman, the drive, and he lays it in.
Strong. He is really strong. Does a great job of using his body to create space.
We approach 1 minute to play. Pressure in the backcourt. 72-64, and Paulus will use a timeout. And even 1 minute left here in Durham. Duke up by 8. coming up tomorrow. CBS Sports runs the table at noon. Supercross followed by the NFL Championship Chase. Then at 2 Eastern, boys and girls high school hoops followed by the best of women's basketball. All here on CBS Sports. Well, Kyle Singler and the Duke Blue Devils looking to close the door on the Georgetown Hoyas. They've got 1 minute left on the clock. Possession of the ball up by 8. And a chance to move their consecutive non-conference winning streak at home to 68 games. They handle the pressure, get it ahead for Paulus. And now can use more clock time here because of the foul call. So Paulus will go to the free throw line. 18 foul against Georgetown. Now the question we posed very early in this broadcast, suffocating defense of Duke against the precision offense of Georgetown. A big caveat though, the fact that Monroe was not in there as often as the Hoyas would have liked to have seen. And a free throw missed by Paulus, so the door is still open here. 45 seconds left. 8-point differential. Georgetown has to work quickly here. Monroe on a kick out. Latan, a three.
What a find.
Latan knocks it down from the perimeter. We've got a 5-point game with 38.2 on the clock.
And Duke still has one more one and one. They're not yet Georgetown in the double bonus here. So there's another possession potentially if they're not able to convert the first free throw. I can still define by Monroe. Triple team, and that's understanding basketball and floor balance. He knew where Watad was on the floor. What an amazing find by Greg Monroe. Wow.
Nolan Smith to the free throw line. 93%. And he nails the first 6-point advantage for Duke. Smart player. Still learning that point guard position, though. That's not the natural spot for him.
It's not, but he brings that intensity defensively. And even today, you know, statistically not a huge impact, but I thought he did a solid job on Chris Wright, not allowing him to run rampant in the interior.
Agreed. The drive by Summers. And controlled by Duke. That should do it. 23 seconds left. Shire looking for some help. Shot clock is turned off. Shire brings it across. And he's waiting for the foul call. He gets it with 15.4. And Duke in front by 7. Chevrolet players of the game here today. DaJuan Summers for Georgetown. Gerald Henderson from Duke. In recognition of continued excellence on and off the court, Chevrolet will make a contribution to each university's general scholarship fund to support the development of new technologies and innovations. Shire at the line. 8-point differential. 15.4 left.
I tell you, I think both teams have to come away feeling somewhat good about where they are as basketball teams. But, you know, obviously disappointment in Georgetown, but they showed when at full strength that they can play with anybody in America.
Watan, short, and that's it. The Duke Blue Devils continue their dominance at home in non-conference games. 76-67, victory.